It's not your ordinary football camp. Young men from Middle Tennessee and Southern Kentucky recently took part in the Armed and Dangerous football camp held recently at Mount Juliet Christian Academy. And as you're about to find out, the players received great instruction from some very qualified coaches.
We're going to explain to you what we want and physically show you exactly what it looks like so there's no gray area.
Steve Calhoun is considered one of the best quarterback coaches in the country when it comes to preparing college players for the National Football League. He and his staff travel across the country conducting football camps for boys in fourth grade all the way up to seniors in high school. Recently, Calhoun took his talents to Mount Juliet, where several boys participated in his Armed and Dangerous camp, a camp designed to help quarterbacks, receivers, and running backs drastically improve their game.
We're based out of Orange County, California, and we train quarterbacks, receivers, running backs, and tight ends for the youth ages 4th through 7th grade and for high school 8th through 12th grade.
If someone doesn't know your background, can you tell me a little bit about your background and what makes you qualified to be in charge of a camp, especially when it concerns the quarterback position?
Absolutely. I've been running my company, Armed and Dangerous Football, for the last 10 years, and I've been fortunate to been able to train Russell Wilson and Cam Newton and Nick Foles and Mike Glennon. And on the receiver side, we have Keenan Allen and Kenny Stills and Robert Woods. And, you know, so through that process of working with them through high school and through college and then getting them ready for the NFL draft.
My understanding is you also worked with Justin Hunter, the receiver for the Titans. Is that right?
That is correct.
What do you remember about working with him?
Well, it was only a couple hours ago, and it was my first time having the opportunity to work with him, so it was really fresh in my mind. His attention to detail. You know, he's really starving to be coached because he wants to be a Pro Bowler. He just doesn't want to be another name, another receiver in the NFL. He wants to be a Pro Bowler and be, you know, labeled as one of those top receivers.
Good. There you go. Excellent. Excellent.
As far as the kids that are going to be here this weekend, obviously they're nowhere near being a pro football player at this point, but what kinds of things do you try to teach them here? Maybe work ethic, just maybe improving their game. What kinds of things do you try to teach?
Well, at Armed and Dangerous, we always like to teach the basic fundamentals of the game. We feel that if you have a great fundamental base, it's able to translate to any level of football that you ever could play on, from youth to high school, and then from college to the NFL. And so that's what we'll be focusing on in this camp this weekend.
And when you do camps like this, do you sometimes notice kids that you go, that kid right there might make it one day?
Absolutely. I mean, you notice that, you know, first of all, you know, from their eyes, if they're paying attention, if they're looking you in the eyes, you know, make sure they're receiving that information. And I have a lot of contacts as far as, you know, with colleges around the country that, you know, I'm in touch with those offensive coordinators and quarterback coaches. And I always, you know, make sure I take the names from kids that work in my camp that I believe that can play at the next level. And I, you know, shoot those names out to the different colleges.
Here we go. Set.
You've been conducting these camps, I think, for about maybe 12 years now. Mm-hmm. Talk about what you enjoy about it 12 years later. What do you enjoy and like about going to different cities or across the country?
It's the look you see in those kids' eyes when they're able to achieve something that they've been working hard on for the last 2 or 3 hours. And maybe in that last hour or the last 30 minutes, they're able to accomplish the movement or, you know, whatever we've been trying to coach.
Good.
And so when you see that look, that sparkle, that smile, you know, that really drives me to come back every day and do a great job with them.
Is that the best part of this for you?
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. Yeah, just being able to offer some of my experience, my playing experience, be able to give back, you know, to these younger kids and help them to avoid some of the pitfalls that they may, you know, fall into or have some of those distractions around them. So just kind of give them a clearer road without all the minefields.
You also mentioned a moment ago Russell Wilson and Cam Newton, and of course they played each other obviously twice this past season, but once in the playoffs. When you watch a game like that, I mean, I'm sure it's hard for you to pull for one or the other, isn't it, at that point?
That's true. You know, I never, people say, hey, do you have a favorite team? I never have a favorite team. I always have my favorite players, and so I'm always rooting for my players that I had the opportunity to work with.
Do they stay in touch with you?
Absolutely, absolutely. I mean, whether it's just a text message or just a hello or, you know, something on their birthday, I always like to just say hey and stay in touch with them.
Detail, there we go. Good.
Calhoun and his staff have been traveling across the country for 12 years now, helping young players perfect their game. Calhoun says while it's nice to work with NFL players, he especially loves helping younger players who have the dream to someday play in the National Football League. Reporting in Wilson County, Barry Hyatt, NCTV.
All that means is that your hand is open on your release.